Today I wanted to go ahead and talk a little bit about what I like to call safe red parries. And what are safe red parries? To me, safe red parries are certain moves that are safe or do minimal damage, obviously depending on situation, if you go for the red parry and mess up. So basically what you're gonna do, basically every character has certain moves where no matter what the situation is, unless you have like no life or something, right? You know, obviously there's certain exceptions, but for most situations every character has certain moves that you should always try to red parry, or that you should at least get into the habit of red parrying. You know, when you guys play casuals and things of that nature, it's not a bad idea to try these things. Because, you know, if you don't try, then, you know, you'll never ever see if you can do it. And so, I'll just go ahead and demonstrate what I'm talking about when it comes to safe red parries. And so, here we have Ken versus Goki. And I'm just going to go ahead and... And so, one move that Goki has that you should, you know, try from time to time to red parry, because you don't really lose anything if you mess up, is his overhead, his torch draw. Now, why is this a quote-unquote safe red parry? Well, it's a safe red parry because Goki can't do nothing if he hits the second hit of the torch of the overhead. In other words, he can't combo or anything into it. And so, you know, and also, you don't really lose a whole lot in terms of, you know, in terms of frames and in terms of advantage, because it's not like you can reversal this anyway. So what am I talking about here? I'm just gonna do the overhead, do a little replay here. Oh wait, I don't wanna red parry. So look at this, watch. Well, let me get the dummy in. Again, I don't really do this very often, so bear with me. How you doing, Kyo? So, let's go through the scenarios. Oh, shit. Alright, that's not good. Well, let me do the short. Okay. So say the Goki player is doing his mix-ups and all that stuff. So notice, right? I can't punish that. I don't know exactly the recovery frames for Torch Strong, but suffice to say, you can't punish this on block. Okay? So you can't punish that on block, but you can punish if you decide to red parry. Oh, hold on. On that note, my food is here. So, we'll be back real quick. Alright guys, so I'm back. Just so Lloyd can splice this video easier, I'm just gonna go ahead and start over. Besides, there's really nobody watching the stream anyway right now. So, today, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go over what I like to call safe red parries. And that is, every character has certain moves that you should try to red parry. Because if you miss the red parry, then all you do is get hit by that particular move. In other words, it doesn't lead to any more increased damage. And of course, there are exceptions to this rule, or to this tactic. If you have no life, going for the red parry is very risky, because if you mess up, then, you know, you get hit by the damage, and then you die, and so forth and so on. But in the course of the game, if you have an ample amount of life, and you want to keep the opponent honest, you want to try and go for these certain red parries, okay? And so, let me just go ahead and demonstrate what I'm talking about one more time. So, here we have Ken versus Goki. And I'm going to demonstrate with the Torch Strong, which is a overhead. Now, what happened here? Guess I was waiting a little too long. Okay. So, now notice that on block, I can't punish this move. Okay? Alright. And of course, Goki is a. I'm pretty sure Goki is at frame advantage. And so, let's just say, you know, the Goki player you're playing is, you know, a tad bit scrubby, and he just kind of does stuff. Okay, well, yeah, that won't work. Well, that particular move. It really depends on what the move is, right? Anyway, long story short, okay? Now, obviously, you can't punish the overhead on block. But you can red parry it. Now, a couple things about red parry, for those of you who aren't too familiar with red parries. Basically, red parry, a parry is red if you're coming right from block stun. Remember that there is an extra frame, of block stun. If you go from crouch to red parry, okay? And so, even if I fuck up the red parry, even if I mess up, so watch. Okay? Right? I don't eat any damage. Like, because why? Because Goki can't combo off the Torch Strong. But if I do get the red parry, again, I'm doing a little too fast. Oh shit. Then I can punish. And then, obviously, I put in the mind of the opponent, oh hey, that guy can red parry that. Oh, that's not completely safe. Which is one of the cool things about 3S, right? There's very few things that are 100% safe. So that's what I mean by a quote-unquote safe red parry. Okay, safe in the sense that if you mess up the red parry, they can't combo off the second hit anyway, or they can't combo off whatever it is that you missed parrying. And so, that one example would be Goki's overhead. Almost every character has certain red parries that are safe. Like, for example, obviously Ryu, right? He has the Torch Strong. Another related note about red parry. To me, actually red parry, I don't know, maybe other people feel this way, but to me red parry is actually easier than normal parry. Because when you do a normal parry, you know, you kind of, there is some anticipation, and you have to guess. But it's almost like the block, like the move that you blocked at first, is your confirmation and your signal to then red parry. I don't know. You can always look at it that way. So obviously, right? That's safe. But if I red parry it, right? If I red parry it, then I can get damage. And so for Gogi and Ryu, there's Torch Strong. That's just one example. Okay. Oro. And remember, they're quote unquote safe because you can't combo off the second hit. So obviously Oro has his overhead fierce, correct? Pretty sure you can't combo off that. Actually, let me double check that before I give wrong information. Yeah, see? Can't combo off it. Now the reason I'm starting off with crouch is because, you know, well, you should always start off with crouch because remember, low attacks have considerably less startup than overheads. Now in the case of Oro, right, in this move, you can actually reversal this outright. See that? You don't even need to be reversal timing. Okay, come on. Alright. But if you want max damage, you can go for the red parry. Okay, come on. Oh, go too fast. Okay. So Oro's is standing fierce, right? Let's just go down the list through all the characters. Let's go to Dudley. Can anyone guess what his quote-unquote safe red parry is? His safe red parry is the target combo. Well, actually, here's the interesting thing about Dudley. Technically, he has a lot of quote-unquote safe red parries because a lot of his target because you can't combo off a lot of his target combos. Okay. So, like for example. And again, oh shoot, Dudley has a ton of these, correct? What the hell? I don't know what happened to my strong. Okay, so that's a very common target combo, right? That's low short, low strong, fierce. Okay. Now, correct me if I'm wrong, Kyo, because you're the Dudley player. But you can't combo off this, right? What the hell? You can't combo off that target combo. Okay. Like, well, actually, can you? No, that doesn't work, Let's try that again. So let's go replay. Yeah, see? That's not a combo, right? So you've been playing this game long enough and then you kind of doubt yourself. Well, it's safe because... Oh, another thing that I neglect to mention. Every time you go for any kind of parry, whether it's a regular parry or a red parry, immediately go back to block. Don't just parry and then leave your dick hanging out, okay? Like... Always parry and then go to block. Okay. So, technically, the interesting thing about Dudley is he has a lot of these quote-unquote safe red parries. Because you can't combo, you can't link anything after that. At least I'm pretty sure you can't. See, watch. He has frame advantage if he makes me block it. But, if I can parry it, I dash. I can punish. So something that is normally, and that's a very common target combo. That's a very common tactic for Dudley players to you know, come up to go up to you and use that target combo. And if you block it, it's safe. Okay. Now let me just make sure that the dummy is on all guard. God, why am I missing my strong? See? Punish. So what's normally is safe isn't. Well, that's... I don't think I can punish off the crouching strong, Dizzy. Yeah, I don't think I can punish. Yeah, see, the fierce is too fast. So, then the Oki is, right? The Dudley player is then, you know, if you say, for example, you show the Dudley player that you could red parry this. God damn it. Why do I keep missing the strong? Okay. Then the Oki is, right, the Dudley player will just not do that last fierce, you see? And then, you know, then the mix-up, then the mind games. Then that's where the mind games go into play. Come on. Now, Dudley has some other things. Like, a real common one is this, right? That's Torrid Roundhouse into Strong. Okay. Right? Safe. Hella safe. If say I fuck up, right? He can't combo off that. I don't think he can. Right? See? So he can't combo off that target combo. He can't link anything off that target combo. And so even if you mess up parrying that forward, you know, you don't get hit by anything other than that. But if you hit the red parry, then look at all the damage that you can get. Trying to think of what other target combos Dudley has. He has so many. No, that's definitely not safe because I think that combos. Pretty sure that combos. Yeah, I'm no Dudley master. Oh, that's one. But nobody uses that. Oh, shit. But anyway, those are the two most common, right? Target. Those are the two most common target normal combos that he does. Okay. The little short, strong, fierce, and the Torrid Roundhouse medium kick. And let's go to another character. Jab, strong, forward, super, yeah. So Dizzy, that would not be a safe one. Because he could do super after that. Okay, so technically, yeah, one, two, no, no, no Triton. Well, you know, it doesn't hurt to practice it, but it's very risky. Because if you try to red parry, we'll get to Yun in a little bit, because Yun's a very interesting case. So the twins are an interesting case. But his 1-2-3, you know, it's... You know, it's because it's kind of a little difficult. It's a little fast. You know, the reason why it's not a safe red parry is because if you fuck up, he can combo into something, and he can combo into Ganesian, which is like the ultimate price that you pay for trying to red for failing to red parry 1-2-3. Okay, so what we're doing is we're finding normals that are relatively safe. In other words, normals where you can, if you fuck up the red parry, if you miss the red parry, all you eat is that damage. Chun's a weird case. Chun doesn't really, I'm trying to think, I mean, yeah, Chun doesn't really have any of that stuff off the top of my head. Something that a lot of, you know, intermediary to beginning Chun players. Now, this isn't technically a safe red parry. I mean, I don't know. I would have to ask Lloyd. I don't know if you would consider this a safe red parry. But what I see a lot of intermediary to beginning Chuns do is, you know, they're looking to confirm back fierce into super, right? And sometimes they'll shoot a fireball in between. But and even if, say, you know, the opponent blocks, the fireball will still come out. And so, damn it. Punish your dash, Dizzy. Damn it, what the hell's wrong with me? Can't even do this. What? Oh my god. What am I doing? Is it right, fireball? Yeah. See, this isn't technically a safe red parry, but what you'll see a lot of Chuns do is sometimes they'll do like back fierce into fireball. You know, and then if they see that you blocked the fierce. Right? It's really hard for them to not go into fireball right after. And so, you know, sometimes there's really no risk, unless they just completely mash super, there's really no risk of going for this red parry attempt. Why am I fucking up? What the hell? There you go. But aside from that, Chun, I don't believe Chun really has any safe red parries. Elena has a ton. I'm not even gonna go there. I haven't really looked at Ibukis, because I don't really know a lot of Ibukis, so maybe Lloyd can do Ibuki and Elena. But some other safe red parries. Well, okay, first of all, Ken, right? Ken's only semi-safe red parry is his back medium kick. This. That's a stupid setup. Let's do this. Yeah, the spin kick, Ibuki spin kick for sure. So, let's see if I timed that right, because I'm doing the dummy, so I did it. It's so hard to do that. How would I record that? Well, whatever. You get the idea. Okay, so... Yeah, Dizzy. You know, the Tatsus, I don't really count it as a safe red parry. Because, once again, if you fuck up the red parry, you know... Like, it depends when you're red parrying. Are you trying to red parry, like, the second hit of the Tatsu? If you're trying to red parry the second hit of the Tatsu, if you mess up, you're gonna get hit by the other Tatsus. You know, if you try to red parry the last hit of the Tatsu, obviously you get knocked down, and I don't think you get anything off of it. So, technically, that's a safe red parry. But remember, right, guys, this tutorial is designed to show you, you know, certain normals that you can red parry with little to no risk. But that doesn't mean that you guys should go for it all the time. You have to think about it in the context of the match. Like, if you keep fucking up the red parry, you know, and you're eating damage and you're giving away spacing and distance for it, don't keep trying it, you know? But in casuals, you know, it doesn't hurt to try these. It doesn't hurt to practice them. Okay, so... Once again. Right? Now here's an example of what... That is not safe. That's not a safe red parry. Just check this out. Well, number one, it's fucking hard to do. But look at that. I can't... Now, technically this isn't a safe red parry, right? But you can make it safe. How? How would I make it safe? Come on. So I don't know if you can hear my buttons, but right after the red parry, I'm pressing strong. Well, I'm mashing it, but... Whoa. See? So that's not a safe. That's not safe. Okay, why? Because the Ken player can cancel into super. Okay, but the back forward is safe. Now let's talk about Yun. Yun's very interesting here. Yun and Yang. So, a common normal that... Oh, fuck. Well, whatever. So, a common normal... Well, the thing about the Kara Demon, though, is if you block the overhead, you're screwed already, right? I mean, that's the whole... You know, I mean... Remember, for the red parry to work, you had to block the overhead. But with Kara Raging Demon, you're not blocking anything. Okay, you know, the character freezes you in block stun. So anyway, so both Yun and Yang have close standing fierce. Now I'm gonna have to check the frame data, but I'm pretty sure they have similar startup and recovery. I may be wrong about that. Maybe somebody on the stream can look it up. Okay. Now, you might think, okay, this is a pretty safe red parry, right? To go for it. But notice, you can combo off different things. Okay, you can combo off slashes. You know, particularly on the wake-up game. You can do slashes. You can do all sorts of stuff, right? Oh, hey, that's stupid. You don't want to do that. Alright, you can do, you know, You can do Dragon Kick. You know, you can do all sorts of stuff, right? Now, this is why it's so important with certain characters to always go back to block. Because even though technically this is not a safe red parry attempt, you can make it safe if you're always going to block after you attempt a red parry. So what am I talking about here? So I'm just going to do the Fierce, and I'm just going to let the Fierce rock, right? Now, obviously, that doesn't combo. Okay? Fuck. Come on. So I decided here I'm going to punish with Crouching Strong Dash Punch, okay? So that's what I'm... Because, you know, obviously my execution sucks, so I can't demonstrate with anything more complicated. So, I red parry the second hit of the Standing Fierce, and I punish with Crouching Strong Dash Punch. But what I'm doing right after the red parry is when I press the Crouching Strong, I go to back first, and then I do it. So it's back, Crouching Strong. So it's down, back, Crouching Strong, Dash Punch. Come on. See? So, right after the red parry attempt, go to down, back. Then punish. Why do you go to down back, you might add, you might ask? Well, there's a reason you go to down back. Because what if the opponent does slashes? I'm gonna do the exact same input, okay? I'm blocking. Why am I blocking? I'm blocking because I went to down back. Right? Pretty simple, right? I went for the red parry there. Oh shit. Okay. But I didn't get hit. Slashes. See? Come on. There you go. And so this works a little easier with Yun, because Yun has different options. So, let's say, let's use Yang versus Yun here. Okay, so, again. Now remember, as long as the Yun player lets the second hit rock, okay? It's safe to do the red parry. But remember, the Yun player can do other stuff. Here's the thing though, you can't confirm this, okay? That's actually, you can't confirm it. But still, the Yun player could do stuff like this. You know, I mean, not that it's smart, but... Or, if he has Ganesian, he could do that. Okay. What's some other stuff he could do? Oh no, that doesn't combo. No, whatever. Okay. So basically he can do a few things. The Yun player can either let the Fierce rock. He could cancel the first hit into Dash Punch, but then that's not confirmable. Or he could do into shoulder. And any strength shoulder, right? Like, I've seen some really smart Yun players, they won't do the jab shoulder. They'll do one that they know won't combo because maybe the opponent's looking for the parry or something. But anyway, that's advanced stuff. So, okay. So, you know, for now, let's just say, okay, there are three options. Let the Fierce rock. Standing Fierce Dash Punch. Standing Fierce Shoulder. Okay. Into the heat of battle, go for it. Now, interestingly enough, depending on the shoulder, right? If you're always timing your red parry to hit that second, to red parry that second hit of the Fierce, as long as you go to block right after the red parry attempt, you should be safe from all of Yun's options. Damn it. What? Okay. Let's try it again. But this time we'll do Dash Punch. Dash Punch is a little tricky, because Dash Punch is really fast. But I know Shoulder. Let's try Shoulder. Let's try that again. Yes. The timing is tight. Let me see exactly once again the Fierce. Also, obviously, you know, this technique with the against this strategy against the Twins, obviously depends on what you're going to use to punish the after the red parry attempt, right? So. Yes. Nika just has to fact check it. So okay, that's back strong, right? Well, yeah. So I went for the red parry. I went to back strong slash. Okay. So now I'm gonna try the dash punch. I think the dash punch can beat this out, but let me see. Oh, okay. Yeah, the timing is a little tight, but I know shoulder, you'll block the shoulder. So watch. If they do standing strong shoulder. Wrong shoulder. See? So I blocked his shoulder anyway. And sometimes you'll parry it. It really depends on when the opponent does the shoulder. And so the twins don't really have any, you know, sort of safe red parries like the other ones. But there are certain things you can do to minimize the risk. You know, one of them obviously is going to block right after attempting the red parry and then punish. And so I know I didn't do certain other characters because, you know, the other ones aren't all that practical. I don't think Makoto has any really safe, quote-unquote, red berries, so to speak. I mean, there's Tord Fierce, but... yeah, I don't really think that's very practical. Ibuki, as Kyo said on the chat, Ibuki's little Rekka kick thing. If you red parry, if you attempt a red parry, she can't get anything afterwards anyway. Alex, too. So, if you have any questions about this, I'll just, you know, email them to House of Strikes or thisisthirststrike.com. This is just something that, you know, Lloyd wanted to cover, and I tried my best to cover it for you. And hopefully, Lloyd can follow up on this whole idea. But remember, guys, you know, this is... just because I showed you the stuff that you could safely red parry, quote unquote safely red parry, doesn't mean that you should always do it. You gotta take into account, you know, the context of the match, whether or not you're hitting it, certain situations, so forth and so on. So, that's my attempt to give you a little set play on the Mutant Experience, and let's go ahead and play some games.